guys, it's Madison. Thanks for joining me in this faithful home. If you are new here, welcome to my channel. I am a Christian homemaker. My husband and I live full-time in an RV, and we are embarking on a mini homestead experience. I love DIY projects, crafting, and building things with my hands, so if any of that interests you, I would love for you to hit that subscribe button so you feel welcomed into this faithful home with me. Recently, I had posted a video on money chat, I think is what I titled it, and I will make sure to leave it up in the cards and down in the description box below for you guys, but it was just a basic overview of how we handle our finances, our thoughts on it, and how we best steward our money. And some of you guys had commented saying that you want to see more in this series, and so today I'm going to be sharing part two. We're going to be talking about credit cards and why I think credit cards are actually important and pretty necessary for young individuals. And yeah, from here on, we're going to have a financial series playlist on this channel. We will talk about all sorts of things when it comes to financing, how we budget, and how we view our money, how we view that it is God's money and it is a gift that He is giving us, and whatever other topics you guys want to see when it comes to money. Make sure you leave those down in the comments below. But let's go ahead and jump on in and talk about why I think that credit cards are actually a good thing. So I don't know where you guys are financially at as you are watching this video. Are you married with kids and in debt? Are you straight out of high school and not knowing what the heck you need to be doing because school doesn't teach you how to balance your checkbook? School probably doesn't even teach you that you have checkbooks anymore. Comment below if you still have a checkbook. I do. Thank you. I learned how to balance money and finances by writing my parents' checks for them when we would go to the grocery store, and I would fill out everything and then they would sign at the bottom. That's not what today's video is about. I just feel like that's a tangent. Welcome to being a 90s baby. You're welcome. So basically, my background on credit cards is when I was 20, I was living with my, well, I should say now I am 25? No, 26? Yeah, I'm 26. Okay, so for me and my experience with credit cards, I am currently 26 years old and married, been married for 2 years, but back when I was 20 and living at my parents' house and single and not having any really big debt or anything because I lived under their roof, I wanted to establish credit for myself because I knew one day I would be out on my own and I would like to have that established credit in my name. My dad was a 30-year banker, and so I learned a lot growing up about money and finances through him, and I'm very thankful for all of the knowledge that he has given me on the topic. And so when I was 20, I decided, yeah, I need to make that next step. I need to establish my own credit card. At the time, I had a steady income because I was a preschool teacher. I did not have any student loans because I went to like 4 years of a junior college and never actually finished my degree. You're welcome. And I had a checking and a savings account. I didn't have any other loans past that. I didn't have anything in my name specifically. The car I was driving, my parents gave to me, but it was in their name, and I never had that financial debt from it, and it was a paid off vehicle. So that was kind of like my background. And then the reason why I wanted to get a credit card was, one, I wanted to establish credit in my name because I knew that when you want to go buy a house or a car or a boat or an RV like we are living in now, you have to show the bank that you can be trusted with your money. And that is where credit comes into play. So a good credit score shows the bank, hey, I can pay my bills off every month, or I am pretty good about keeping a steady budget for when it comes to the debt to income ratio that I have. And I knew that I wanted to set myself up from a younger age, knowing that I didn't know when I was going to get married, when I was going to move out, when I was going to buy a house, car, boat, RV, motorcycle, whatever you want. We don't have a boat. Well, I guess we have jet skis, but we didn't buy them. Anyways, I didn't know when any of that was gonna happen. So I wanted to set myself up in the right direction from the very beginning. So there are many different ways that you can go about it. I actually went to a local bank because, like I said, my dad was a 30-year banker. I grew up growing into the bank. There wasn't online banking when he started out. You couldn't pay all your bills online, move money over at 3 in the morning because you needed to buy something and you didn't have the funds in your checking account. There wasn't any of that. You went in person, you went to the tellers, you went to the ladies at the front that gave you lollipops and chocolate because they knew you and you came in every single week. And I absolutely love the small banking community feel. You go in, they greet you by name, and you get to do more than just business with them. You are interacting with them and building relationships with them. So I wanted to go somewhere that was that small bank feel. The only downside, I will say, is that with it being a small local branch, I wasn't qualified for any credit card. Like, there are a lot of opportunities, which I will get to here in a little bit, about credit cards that you can qualify for without ever having any credit in your name. This wasn't the case with this branch, so when I went, I knew I wanted to work with them, and I actually have my business through them now, and I'm very, very happy to be able to work with them. But when I first went and inquired about getting a credit card in my name, they said, you actually don't qualify unless you co-sign with someone. So I didn't have any credit in my name, and so since my mom co-signed with me, she was going to be on the account. And I think that also creates a level of bond and trust that I have with my parents, that my mom literally signed a credit card partially in her name, partially in my name. When we established this credit card, they said, okay, your limit is going to be $500 a month, just a very basic entry level credit card. And looking back, I could have done more research on getting ones that gave me more cash back options or benefits and rewards. But at the end of the day, I am glad that I went through them because I was able to create that relationship with them. So would I change it? No, but were there better options at the time? Probably. But I set this up with my mom. I had a $500 limit, and I gave myself a task to only buy groceries with this credit card. My mom had her own that she just put in a drawer, and probably it has expired by now because it's been like 6 years. So, but basically, I had shared this in the last video that I used it for only buying groceries. So I would go to Kroger or I would go to Walmart and I would pick up groceries, and that was all I used the credit card for. And then at the end of the month, I would pay off everything on that card. Credit card companies don't actually like when you pay your card off at once, because then they can't use that interest that they're gonna incur to make more money off of you. So you're actually not their biggest fan when you pay it off every month, but you're a big fan to yourself when you do, because you're not accruing any interest, any extra debt that is not necessary, and you're budgeting and allowing you only to spend what you have. I think it's funny that I was so fixated on that this credit card could only be used for groceries that I literally went to Target and wanted to buy something else and thought, I can't use this credit card because it's not for groceries, and then realized, yes, indeed, you can use it. It is a normal credit card, Madison. You just told yourself it can only be for groceries, and you had that mindset, which is good. It's good to establish that mindset, but I could do a lot more than just groceries, but I kind of made it a habit of only doing that. So I would keep track of everything that I spent. I had like a logbook, or like I was mentioning at the beginning of this video, checkbooks. They have like the little thing at the end of the checkbook that you can track each check number, where you spent it, how much you spent, and all that. So at the beginning, I was very diligent about tracking every single thing that I spent and knowing how much I owed at the end of the month. And then for me, my credit card bill came out on the 15th of every month, and so that's when I would pay it off. And I still have that account to this day. It's been 6 years. It's great. I haven't even upped my limit, which probably can by now, but I like to keep it at 500. It's a good like small number. That way I can continue to accrue that credit but not be tempted to go past it. I think it is actually really smart and important to consider getting a credit card when you are fresh out of high school, only if you believe that you really can keep it in track, pay it off at the end of the month, and not accrue debt, because that is where you will really harm yourself. Credit cards are a great thing, in my opinion. I do not fully believe in the Dave Ramsey method because he doesn't believe in credit cards at all. I strongly urge people that if you can be diligent with it, or you can set the limit really low on your credit card, that you do that. You get a credit card and start establishing it in your name. That way, when you go to buy a house, you can actually buy the house because you can show that you have credit and you can prove to them that you can pay your monthly bill off every time. And so I think it is very important. It shows a great sense of responsibility. It puts something on you that's very tangible. And then the reward after that is that you can then purchase a car, a house, an RV, a boat, a motorcycle. The list goes on and on of things that if you need to get a loan, a bank is going to look at you with more respect and a better outcome of lending you the money if you show them, look, over the past 5 years, I've had my credit card, I've paid it off every month, my credit score is really high, and it just shows them that level of maturity and responsibility. So I am a big proponent of it. I disciple this girl, Blue. We meet every other week, and we actually got on this topic last time we met about credit cards, and that's what kind of prompted me to make this video today, is talking about establishing credit in your name. And I highly suggested to her that she sit down and have a conversation with her parents about establishing credit. And I think that's a good thing to have. I don't think they teach that to you in school. She goes to a public school, and schools teach you trigonometry, but they don't teach you how to balance a checkbook or how to pay your credit card every month and not accrue a fee. And I think that is something that is wrong with our school system, and one of the reasons why when we have kids, it probably will end up homeschooling, but that's for another day. So I think it is very important to establish that credit and to keep yourself in check with it. Things to look for. I did make a note here on things to look for when you are getting a credit card, especially if you are super new to the game. There's a thing on every credit called an APR, and that stands for your annual percentage rate. This is going to be your rate of which you owe if you don't pay your credit card off in time. So say that you owe $1,000 on your credit card, and then you only paid off the quote unquote bare minimum requirement, which is what credit cards do to make you think that you only have to pay a little bit now and you could pay the rest off later and it's fine. You'll only accrue a little bit of a fee. Well, some APRs can be up to like 23%. That's a lot of money. So every month that you're not paying off your credit card, you're racking up extra money that you owe the credit card company because you didn't pay it off in the first place. And that's what APR is. And don't let that number scare you, because there are a lot of like first-time credit card offers out there that have a pretty high APR. But if you know and you are diligent and you know that you are responsible enough to pay it off every month, then that number is not too scary. It's the ones that don't think they can pay the credit card off every month that's probably watch out for this number and probably shouldn't get a credit card in the first place if you don't think you're financially ready to make that commitment. Another thing to look for are annual fees. So my credit card has no annual fees. So if there is a credit card that has like a $30 annual fee, every year you have to pay $30 to the credit card company to keep active this credit card. Probably more so if there's like really big rewards within it and you get like a lot of cash back or something, they may have an annual fee. Now, this fee may be beneficial for you if you know that you're going to use the credit card a lot and you are going to pay it off in time. Remember, that's a key thing in this video, is paying it off every month. But if you know that you're gonna use it for big purchases, it may be worth it to have an annual fee, but I would just keep that in mind, looking into it. That way you're not thrown off by a $50 fee every year and you barely use your credit card and you pay it off every month. That's still $50 that you're gonna have to spend. So check the risk reward and whether or not it's worth it to have a credit card with annual fees. A lot of credit card companies offer cash back reward program, meaning like every dollar you spend at the grocery store, you get 1%. Cash back, or when you spend it on gas, it's 2%. In big businesses, it's 3%. Things like that. Those are things to look for when you get a credit card. One of the things I mentioned earlier that I did not look into when getting my first credit card, and might I add my only credit card right now, is I didn't look for the cash back thing. I didn't look for the percentage back because that wasn't on my mind. I knew it was a thing, but I also wanted to go local and small, and so I kind of outweighed those things, but I didn't look into it too much. And part of me wishes that maybe I would have looked at getting a credit card with a cashback program, because for every dollar that you spend somewhere, you get a percentage back. Then at the end of the year, you can cash that in for like gift cards to restaurants or put it towards a trip or straight up cash. And so those are things to look for when getting your first credit card. There's also a credit limit that comes on every credit card. It's how much the credit card company will allow you to spend every month. So like I mentioned, my credit card limit is $500 a month. It probably can go up by now because I've had it for 6 years. I've just never asked because I'm okay with it being a $500 limit. I'm pretty sure that David's credit card that he has an Apple card, and I think his is like $3,000 or $4,000 limit or something like that. So there's a varying level. There are credit card limits that are like $10,000, and it's all about your comfortability and what you make and what you spend in a month. Are you okay with having a larger monthly limit? Knowing that you either A, won't go to that limit, or B, will still pay off that limit every month? Or would you feel more comfortable having a credit card that is, say, like a $1,000 limit a month, and then you can buy more of your monthly necessities with that and pay it off with your income at the end of the month? But it gives you a little bit more wiggle room for things like cash back. So I can spend $1,000 a month and get 1 or 2% cash back on things and kind of rack up those bonuses. That's one thing that you need to keep an eye out for, and you need to watch and make sure that you know and track when you have a higher limit. Because if a credit card company gives you a $4,000 limit and you're just swiping your card willy-nilly, not thinking about it, never hitting that limit, and all of a sudden you get to the end of the month and your bill comes in and you owe $3,500 and you just don't have that because you didn't keep track of it, is that something that you're gonna wanna risk? For me, with my $500 limit, one thing I like about it is when I get close to that limit, if I try to make a transaction that'll put me over, it'll decline it, which is really nice for me. So right now I don't exactly track it because I know at the most my credit card's gonna be $500, and I know that we're financially okay with that, so I'm not as structured about tracking anymore because we do have two incomes. But that is something to keep in mind because I know that maybe my credit card's around $350. If I go to the grocery store and it's a $200 transaction, I swipe the credit card, it's gonna reject it because that'll put me over that $500 limit. Then I know, oh hey, I'm close, I need to go pay off my credit card, that'll put me back to zero, and repeat again and again. So something to consider. One more thing that I will finish with is the accessibility to paying it. Are there online banking options? Is there an easy way to pay off your credit card every month, or are you needing to go in person? Now, I am one of the exceptions. I do love getting to go in person every month and pay my credit card. They do have an app, and I could use that app to pay my credit card off every month, but I choose not to use the app. I choose not to even have it because, one, I know that 500 is my limit, so I'm okay and I won't go crazy spending on my card, but two, I like going and having that personal one-on-one connection with the tellers at the bank. So every single month, I go to the bank physically. I usually do it while I'm working, that way it's kind of easy and convenient. I pay my credit card bill off, I chit chat with them for 5-10 minutes, and then I see them again next month. And I think I really enjoy that personal connection more than using my phone. But something you want to consider is there an online banking app for your credit card? Is it going to be really streamlined and easy for you to pay that credit card off every month? Or are you going to forget because you have to go in person, and that's another step on your plate to take? So that is one big thing to consider, is how easy and accessible it is to pay your credit card off. All right, guys, I've been rambling on for 21 minutes about credit cards, and I think I'm going to wrap this video up here. I hope you guys enjoyed me talking about credit cards and why I actually think they are beneficial and why you should learn about managing your money and having a credit card and the benefits and drawbacks that it can have on your personal budget and finances. I really enjoy talking about money and finances with you guys. I am glad that this is the second video I've made in that series, and I think I'm going to continue this series more. Make sure to leave down in the comments below suggestions on money chat topics that you guys want me to cover here on this channel, because I want to share as much knowledge and information that I have with you guys. And if I need to go ask my dad, who was a 30-year banker, I could probably go on a way more long-winded ramble for you guys about those topics. So make sure you let me know what you want to hear in the next money chat video. If you haven't already, I would love for you to hit that subscribe button so you feel welcomed into this faithful home with me. It really does help out my channel when you subscribe, like, comment, and interact with me, because it shows YouTube that they should really promote these videos, and I work really hard on these videos and I enjoy making for you guys, so I want them to get to a lot more people. So thank you so much if you already have subscribed, and if you haven't, make sure to click that red button down below for me. I try my best to post videos every Wednesday at 3 p.m. Eastern, so I will check back with you guys next week for another video. Bye, guys!